we can. Welcome, everybody. I'm Greg Davis, and this is Taskmaster. Lazy journalists often ask me, hey, Greg, what would you be like as a competitor on Taskmaster? And my answer is always the same. Does your mum like being kissed with that dirty mouth? Does she? I'm the Taskmaster. Before every series, I spent 6 months training with Shaolin monks in the hills of China. What should I use my jacked body to throw toilet paper around Gatwick Airport? Should I use these skills to throw cottage pie through a big pipe? Yeah! Fortunately for you, there are 5 people here who will take on such challenges. They are... Dara Bree! Fern Brady! Sean Kearns! Munya Chihuahua! And Sarah Milliken! And next to me, the man who is the answer to the question, what do you get if you cross a really boring chemistry teacher with another really boring chemistry teacher?
I love spending time with you.
Banter time.
Mm-hmm.
Let's do it.
Let's do it. Let's just play a game of mind noughts and crosses. Do you want to do that? Could you? Would you?
Sure.
Okay. I'm noughts.
Okay. Is it my go?
I wouldn't have done that.
It's your board.
Okay. I know. Yeah.
Alex.
Yes, Greg?
I've got an erection.
Oh.
Right, I'm on a pie slice.
Well, this week, you've asked them to bring in the best fancy dress. Greg will judge the best fancy dress, and then the winner of the episode will take home 5 very fancy dresses. Simple as that.
Right. Fern.
I am dressed as an alien dressed as a Scottish man.
Yes, this is Fern's fancy dress. Have a look.
Like educational films for children. This was a film where there's a Scottish book called The Cone Gatherers about 2 brothers, and for some reason I was an alien that inhabited the character of the book, but I'm not a not what people would call a thespian, and I got shot dead in the end.
Right.
Why was the alien shot?
I was shot because I wasn't meant to be gathering cones in the forest.
I feel like possibly my drinks have been spiked.
Incredible.
Good luck, Dara.
I brought in a plague doctor's mask.
This is Dara wearing his plague doctor's costume.
Oh! Now, I find that immediately unsettling.
Yeah.
We have got a close-up of the mask.
That's the actual mask, it's the plague doctor's mask. But the plague doctor's mask has no air holes in it, so really quickly the windows steam up and you have to keep reaching your hand into it and windscreen wiping the little glass windows. So that was bad. I think I started lifting it up onto my head. So people go, what, are you a unicorn?
It's genuinely creepy. It's quite a thing. John.
Do you like fancy dress?
I don't enjoy it at all.
Neither do I. So what I do is I bring in my pocket an inflatable walking stick. You can be Charlie Chaplin, Willy Wonka,
yeah.
The bloke from Up.
I don't like giving you 1 point in this round, you know that?
Well, I don't think it deserves 1 point, even though it clearly says one up there. Yes.
I feel good about this.
Okay.
So, I have bought in the most accurate replica of a spacesuit
ever made.
Accurate.
And just to try and tip you over to 5 points, I've actually got a video of me in the suit.
It's not bad, man. It's not bad. Sarah.
So, from the age of 16 to 21, I worked at WH Smith's, and every Christmas Eve, we were allowed to get dressed up.
Yep.
And then one of the years, nobody else wanted to, apart from me and my friend. So we decided to do bad taste. Oof. And we borrowed some clothes from my friend's mum.
Sorry.
And we wore them. And nobody noticed. We just looked like we were from South Shields. Which is where we were.
I don't think it's that bad.
I'd wear that. All right, then, scoring time.
The trouble is, I like the spirit of John's, but it's obviously the worst fancy dress.
Oh, by miles, by miles.
Yeah, by a country mile. Give him 1 point. I don't think Sarah's dress is that fancy. I'm going to give her 2 points. Because Dara's and Munya's are shop-bought fancy dress, I'm going to give them 3 points.
3 points each?
Yes. Ooh. Because we all know there's got to be a gulf between anything and that monster. The bloody alien boy.
All right.
5 points.
All right. All right.
Okay, this is the first task involved.
It involves dash dot dash dot dash 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 dot dot dot. Hi, John.
Yeah.
Fern.
Hiya.
Dara.
Oh.
Excuse me.
Yes. Do the table check.
Nothing your side?
No.
Nothing this side.
Is everyone well?
Yeah, you know.
Straight in.
Come up with a secret language that doesn't use words.
You have 10 minutes after which one of you must go to the lab. Your time starts now.
What if we had, like, broader categories so this could be, like, punch?
Why is that your first word?
So, punch.
No, I'm not going for this.
So that can be yes. Oh, that could be no, yeah.
You, me, us. Hard, yeah. Hard, medium, gently.
One of my key words in my life is not gently.
You know, the most common word in the world is... Right, what are we going to do? It's very difficult when you don't know what you're going to be talking about.
Yeah, it is
exactly. Common
yeah.
Words.
It's like, or something.
Oh, Jesus.
Do or noun?
Okay. But you know how many nouns there are?
A to E is yellow.
I'll give you an instruction, so... So...
I... Verb... Oh, no, you nailed it. I, verb, medium.
What you then do is you get these sticks and you use that for the subject matter. There's literally no fault in this method.
A, B, C...
Yes, 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 yes,
D,
yes.
E, F, R...
And then for the letter
F,
you use...
D, U, V.
So... You use a number...
You add a stick.
I don't know if you're a genius or a madman.
If we get this right, then it means the code works, OK?
If we get this right, it'll be a bloody miracle.
Right.
Manya, please go to the lab.
Oh, good luck!
A team of two. Mm.
Yeah.
The first word was suggested by Manya was the word punch.
Yeah.
That was his first word.
That's his first word. And he followed it up with lick.
Yeah, but most situations can be solved by a punch or a lick. Tell me any situation.
Now. Actually, you're right.
There you go. What's this, John? The most commonly used word in the world is
I heard it on the radio. And everyone anywhere in the world understands, huh?
What?
I don't understand it now.
No. Let's see it in action, come on.
Yeah, let's see the iVerb medium team. It's Sarah and Munya.
Secretly give this instruction to your teammate. You may not say or write any of the words in the instruction. If fastest wins. Your time starts as soon as you walk through the door and stops when the instructions are carried out by your teammate. Should be easy.
Time has started.
You. Mm-hmm. Herb. Mouth. Speak. Shout. Eat. You feed. Noun. God, I hope this is harder or gently coming up soon. You feed the cat. You feed a giraffe. Ah, you feed the giraffe. You feed the giraffe. Oh, and this is horrifically working. Is there punching coming up? Because I know that one. You feed the giraffe and elephant. Is that it? Three. You feed the giraffe and the elephant down along three times in the clown's mouth. Jesus Christ! Three times! Yeah? Okay. Three.
I've stopped the clock.
Oh my God! Well done!
Well, I was a bit disappointed that no one got fed hard or punched, but what looks like absolute chaos worked a treat.
I'm still surprised that it worked and I was there.
Right. Find someone to spoon for 5 minutes because we're going to have an advert break. Alex! Oh. Where there's a code-creating task on the go.
No, I don't think so, Greg. I'm just kidding, there is. The team of two's unorthodox codes seemed to work. In the end, they fed three giraffes and an elephant to the clown. Let's see how Dara, Fern and John got on.
Yeah. BBA.
Yes!
Right, I think that's B. C! What? Why are you holding two sticks? Is it A? Is it B? Is it C? Is it D? Is it E? Two E's!
Oh, I think the next letter is D.
D. B! B! I don't understand. I don't remember. T. Okay, we're back. We're back.
H. Is it R? Yeah. Is the next one E? Yeah, E.
Feed three.
Ducks.
See?
E, that means E. Yeah.
It's been so far five E's.
X.
Well, that can only be L, M or N.
Elephants.
Ooh, maybe.
That's a P.
Is it elephants?
No, he can't say that. We have to pretend that the language works.
Well, the language does work.
Yeah.
Feed three elephants and... Yeah. A giraffe. Oh, here we go.
Next word, please.
A.
C.
How is
C.
it C? How is it C?
Because it is.
Oh!
L.
It's clown. Feed three elephants and a giraffe to the clown.
Christ almighty.
Thank you, team.
My impression formed of the non-dingers. Fern was of more use to you on this occasion.
Fern was a joy to work with, a pleasure to be around. Yes, we were on the same wave, but I did work really, really well.
Yeah.
That's all I want to say about that task.
And if you wanted to go to a fancy dress with one of them, you'd go with her, right?
I would. Yeah, yeah. I mean,
it's like some prick with a blow-up walking stick. John, anything you want to say in your defence?
My brain doesn't work like that.
Your brain doesn't work? Yeah.
Oh, never mind. Maybe there's some points to be had.
Well, as you saw, Fern and John fed three elephants and a giraffe to the clown, but Sarah fed one elephant and three giraffes to the clown, so only one of them's got it right.
Whichever team turn out to have fed the correct animals into the clown will get 5 points, and if they fed the wrong animals into the clown, there will be no points.
No points. That is...
What?
Because the task wouldn't have been completed.
That was harsh.
But I don't know who did it.
Well, you could still be a nicer person. Oh.
So the team of three thinks it's three elephants. If they're right, they win.
Feed three elephants and a giraffe to the clown.
Feed three giraffes and an elephant to the clown.
Which means the team of two win 5 points each.
Oh, wow. That's crushing.
That is tough. That is entirely my fault, and I apologise about everything I said about John.
Score.
Yes, Manya, of course, yet to win an episode, as is Fern, but they're both in with a shot in this one. Fern is on 5, Manya's in the lead with 8 points!
Yes!
Ooh. Come on!
Right, what is next, please?
Well, there's something pretty alluring. Hi, Sarah.
Hello.
Hello, Fern.
Can I walk in like that?
Wow, that was really nice.
Right. Pin an alluring tail on the alluring animal while blindfolded.
Pin the tail on the donkey.
You have 15 minutes to find the alluring animal. Ooh, make an alluring tail.
Put your alluring tail on the tail station and prepare to pin your alluring tail on the alluring animal.
Blindfolded!
Starting from here. Fastest wins.
You have to now try to find the alluring animal. What animals do you find alluring?
The Cadbury's bunny.
It's out the front!
Aha!
Is it him?
So that's the alluring animal.
Is it alluring?
No, I'm not a pervert.
So now we need an alluring tail.
So the tail station is that circle in the middle of the lawn.
What's in here? That might be sexy.
I mean, that's quite an alluring tail in itself.
What about flowers up his butt?
It's actually lovely.
I'll use this. What is it, a toilet brush? It looks kind of used. No, don't sniff it.
The Cadbury's bunny, yeah?
Oh, she's fictional, so that's all right.
So it's pinned the tail on the donkey, but we gave them 15 minutes to prepare their tail, but that's really a distraction from preparing their route from tail to tiger.
Good.
Let's begin with good old Dara and good young Manya.
Alex?
Yes?
Do you know what I'm going to do?
No.
I'm going to make a long path.
Right, OK.
I need to keep to the right-hand side of this. Take this as far as you can. OK, stop. All right. Drop.
Drop.
Right, I'm ready.
Right.
I have to go back to town, don't I?
Yes, please. When I blow the whistle, you must pin your alluring tail on the alluring animal.
Just need to find the door. Okay.
Corridor. And then out here. Now, obviously, steps.
Okay. Whoa. I can hear my voice pinging off some sort of dome.
Turn 90 degrees. 1, 2, 3. There. Oh, not quite. That's how this has to happen. Right.
It's about keeping a low centre of gravity, Alex.
I can see that.
Like a coiled hedgehog.
Piano, piano, piano.
Yes! Ready?
foot! Yeah!
Stop the clock. The head of a luring animal, bum of a luring animal. Saucy.
I have stopped the clock. Thank you, Dara.
I'm not sure how alluring Munya's tiger was after it had been violently...
tailed. Let's have a look at his alluring tiger after it had been tailed. Yeah.
No, but the thing is, in my defence, if that is a toilet brushes go near bottoms, which are alluring.
You know you don't clean your bum with a toilet brush, do you?
And you certainly don't clean your bum with a toilet brush that deeply. You're on your feet most of the time, Dara, and I hope you don't take what I've written down as an insult here.
I'm clearly about to have to take that. Go on.
I've put, Dara has a very upright, dainty walk for a big man. Full stop, like one of those Spanish horses that can dance. You got some time?
I do. Dara, 3 minutes exactly. Munya, 2 minutes and 6 seconds. In the lead at the moment. So well done, Munya. OK, it's Fern and Sarah now.
So can I just go in here and be blindfolded?
Yeah, when you come out, are you going to be coming out the front? Are you having a practice or what are you doing?
Huh?
Do you just want to start?
Yes!
OK, I'm coming.
12:18:4.
Yeah.
Your time starts now. Do be careful.
I don't have very good spatial awareness when I'm not blindfolded.
Right.
Oh, there we go. There's the door. Oh, no, that's not a door. So this was where the 18 started. So
right.
One, two...
Oh, no!
What's your system now, Fern?
I just have to keep waving my arms.
Right.
Oh, there's the glove.
Is the house there?
I don't think so.
If the hedge is there, is the hedge there?
No.
So there's a wagon wheel, and then it's 4 steps. I'm going to shuffle till I hit it with my feet.
Feels minging. Okay.
Oh, I found my tail. I should have counted how many steps. Why didn't I do this bit?
Am I going to walk into anything?
Where do you think you are?
Near the piano.
Right.
Am I not?
No.
Where is it? Where is it? Oh. Oh, God!
Oh, that's the cow! Ooh. Hello, are you here?
Where is it? Where is it?
Ah, there he is!
I'll feel the heat of his body.
Done!
I've stopped the clock.
Oh, done.
I've stopped the clock, Fern. You... Oh.
Two very contrasting styles. Sarah used a step-counting system to complete the task with reasonable efficiency. Fern stumbled around, waving her hands in front of her while shouting, "Where am I?"
Narrative that I don't have systems and I just flounder around.
What was the system then?
Well, there might not have been a system other than I was going to use the one that bats do where you like make a clicking sound.
And I've been far kinder in my summary if you have.
Okay, well, Sarah's method sort of worked. She just felt her way there in 9 minutes and 40 seconds.
Okay.
Not good.
Not great. But comparatively not bad. Fern, you took 13 minutes and 53 seconds to cover 25 metres. If you did the marathon at that rate, it would take 16 days and 8 hours.
3, 2, 1, advertising! Oh! Here we are again, the third part of the show.
Ooh, nice work, Greg. Someone's been practicing. Before the break, the five competitors were trying to plan how best to pin a tail on an alluring animal once blindfolded. Fern Brady does not make plans. Now, finally, what will John Kearns do?
You think a blindfold's gonna do me?
In we go. Your time starts.
Right. Now, I've planned for this. I don't remember it being this far away. Well, I left it here. Have you moved it?
No.
No, no, he says.
It's there, John.
It's not there. God, am I there? I'm at the door. Well, it's there.
Well, OK.
It's right there.
I'll pick it up, then.
Ah! Oh. Where's the string? Where's the tail? The tail was on top of the tail station.
Yeah, it still is.
The bit of no, it's not. It's not, because I just picked up the tail station. My planning. I tell you, I thought I was doing this in under a minute or something. Is that the piano? Yes. Stop the clock.
Well done, John.
I don't quite know what went wrong because it looked really promising.
It just disappeared. And then I accused the team of...
Yeah, you were very cross. You thought we'd moved your tail.
Yeah,
you were convinced.
I got a bit angry. I apologise.
For a couple of hours.
I think that once you did find the tail, you walked away like a grandfather in a sitcom. I could be wrong.
Let's see if he did.
Tell me some time.
Yes, well, 1 point to Fern with her 13 minutes 53. 2 points to Sarah. Then it was John with his 8 minutes and 12 seconds. Dara, of course, 3 minutes. But the fastest by quite some distance was Monia. He gets another 5 points.
Wow. Wow. Right, another one.
OK, yes, and I have an extremely handy one ready now. Oh. So let's see it.
OK, this is sinister.
Monia!
I've brought a little comfort animal along. I've abducted him.
Press your hand on the table.
Oh! Oh.
Find the back of your hand.
Oh, no!
Fewest wrong guesses wins.
You have a maximum of 20 minutes.
And your time starts when Alex does a hand pun.
I think I should be able to do it because I have really big, weird hands that look like roofers.
All hands on deck. Just to reassure you, you are in safe hands.
Was that a pun?
Yeah.
OK.
You are going to have to do it single-handedly.
Exactly what they have to do.
Yes, so on the very first day they arrived in the house, I took a Polaroid of their hands.
Yeah.
In that garage, there were 3,000 other hands.
Yeah.
Hands of our viewers, in fact. Thank you for sending your hands in, if you did. The first people we're going to see have some very similar hands, all four lovely and soft. It's Dara and John.
I remember someone's Desert Island Discs. He was playing the piano. He was looking down at his hands. And he realised he was looking at his father's hands. You know, I'm looking for not just my hands, but my dad's hands.
I don't think your dad's hands are here.
Is there any clue?
For sale, reject boards, 100 guesses.
So I can tell you which board it's not, but it'll cost you 100 guesses for each board.
That's not what we're going to do.
OK.
There's got to be something clever about this. There's got to be some other way of doing this.
What's that?
Oh, I wouldn't touch that, but...
What'd you say?
I said I wouldn't touch that.
It's that hand, so there'd be no ring on it.
It's your hand there, please, your left hand.
It's that hand, so there'd be no ring on it.
Whose hands are those?
Is that your first guess?
Yeah.
Wrong.
Right, eliminate two boards.
Well, there's a dog there.
These are all wrong fingers, if you want to dip in there.
Yeah, these two. Left pinky, right pinky.
200 guesses. It's half your time gone.
How many boards are there?
Eight.
I want to get rid of seven.
Here's what we're going to do. Two more.
Gone. I'm not on there. 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 I'm
in. You've now had 701 guesses.
Fuck it.
That one?
No.
Is it that one?
No.
Right, you're saying no quickly. It got to be somewhere where you're stood over there and you could go, yeah, it's that one. Is it that one?
No.
Is it that one?
No.
Now you paused there. It's around here.
30 seconds.
I'm just going to go mad staring at these.
No.
It's around here. You started pissing yourself around here. It's that one. Come on.
Das.
No.
Das. Das.
Was it that one?
No.
So many hands. They all look the same. Where is my hand?
Thank you, Dara.
Down there. The super hands.
John, you know that whole dad's hands thing?
Yeah.
Yeah, what are you on about?
Russell Watson.
Yeah.
So he said he was playing the piano one day and then he looked down and he was like, God, I've got my dad's hands.
What you're saying is, and the opera singer Russell Watson says in an interview you saw with him, he realises his hands look like his dad's. And that affected your system here of looking for your hands when you had your own fucking hands in front of you. Why bring your dad into this at all?
It's easier to look for your dad's hands than your own.
Dara, you hampered yourself by picking the wrong hand.
See, I made a mistake. I was looking for my auntie's hands. because Placido Domingo said to me once...
John, at one point, I'm fairly sure that you chose a black hand.
Those are my dad's.
Advert time. If your partner is off making the tea and they've got PJs on, why not sneak up behind them and pull the PJs down and shout, look, kids, the moon is disgusting tonight. It's your break. Do what you want. We'll see you in a minute. Closing part of today's show. There was a creepy task in play, I believe.
You're right, Greg. I got pictures of loads of hands, stuck them on a wall, and then locked the competitors in the garage with them. I'm so weird. Next, to try and find their hands amongst over 3,000 other hands are Munya and Fern.
High five. Oh, yeah. Hey, wait a minute. Ooh.
So we're looking for a fat, square palm. Oh, that hand's horrible! That's like a demon's hand.
So, there's two mirrors. One has a little square in it, one plain. So surely I need to ping it off the second mirror, don't I? Now, if I get it at just the right angle, it will point directly at my hand. Yes, there you go. That ain't my hand.
For sale, reject boards. Yeah, can you do that? Left middle and right pinky.
Oh, you lot think you're smart. Oh! You know, because I'm stretching, is this boiler suit giving me a camel toe?
Hey, don't pan down, man. What are you doing?
Would you like to rule out any more board, Fern?
Yes. Left wedding. Right middle, left index. OK.
What the hell? So now I've gone from having to look from my own hand to a tiny pinprick of laser.
This one?
That's not your hand.
Yeah, too fat.
Aha! Yes! You know what? This is my hand.
I've stopped the clock.
This one! This hand!
That is your hand.
That's my hand!
Come on!
I really dug out one hand in particular, but it was a strange-looking hand, to be fair.
Yeah, I insulted a lot of the hands, but this is speaking as a person who hates my own hand.
Yeah, she was looking for a hand that's dehydrated. She said, what face does my hand make? And my hand doesn't bulge.
Did I say that?
Mm-hmm. And then you asked, who invented right and left and what's it for?
Mumia, I thought watching you in action was like watching an episode of CSI right up until the point you announced you had a camel toe.
When I used to go to Laser Quest in Norwich,
yeah,
every time I used to go, it was full of, like, ex-Marines, so I'd always just be killed instantly. So what I had to do is I had to learn to get into little corners and look for reflective surfaces and then ping them off the top like that. So I've walked into there and I've gone, this is what the training was for.
So... Munya took one guess, got it right.
Wow!
So it's going to be tough to beat.
Wow! How many guesses did Fern take to find a big old hand?
So she used 504 guesses.
All right, who's left?
It's Sarah Milliken.
I know how I had my hand photographed.
How was that?
Everybody else is going to do that, so I'm going to do that.
OK.
Well, that should help.
It should help, shouldn't it? Because it should stand out more than all the losers who just put the hand normal. No. OK. It's weird how hands don't look like hands anymore when you look at them so much. And now some of them just look like loads of parsnips. Ah! Found it.
It's correct.
I don't know what to say. It's just some sweet forward planning.
Obviously, I didn't know what the task was going to be, and I genuinely just thought it was funny to look like I was whacking a cock. I was just going for the joke.
Well, Sarah and Munya both just a single guess, so they both get 5 points. Fern, 4. The others, 0. Sarah and Munya are the winners!
What a blow. Well done. Let's have a quick look at the scores.
Right, well, John, rock bottom with 4 points. Munya, rock top with 18 points.
Please make your way to stage for the final task of the show! Who'll be reading out the final task?
Dara Breen.
Hit it.
Guess the fully extended length of the extendable item. Closest to the fully extended length wins.
Sounds pretty high octane.
Oh, yes. OK, so it's a team task. We have little markers. So you make your guesses as a team, but one of you can go out on the nappet and put down where they think it will go. The other person has to stay on their spots.
And are we allowed to lie down to measure things?
Is that how you normally measure things? We're going to start with the feather duster. And, Dara, you go first.
OK. I don't think you want me to do my catchphrase.
I want you to do a catchphrase.
Let's mash it.
I think Fern agrees with that, yeah?
Yeah, yeah.
You think?
I agree with it as well, yeah.
Happy with that, team?
Yeah.
So, I want you to see how many ridges has it got?
7.
That's a lot, isn't it? I think further.
Further?
They've got, yeah.
Yeah, because the thing is, you've got to get those extra high cobwebs. No one's getting short cobweb.
Team of 3 has gone shorter, team of 2 further. Are you going to invite me to extend?
Please, use your own hands to extend.
He's off.
Oh, he's off.
Yes, The team of two get the first point. We're moving on to the dog lead. And it's Sarah to measure first.
I think it's really long.
That's too far because if you need to pull it back suddenly, you shouldn't be having to do this.
Oh, no, I do that all the time. It's like pulling in the end of a hoover. My dog flies back.
All right, go on, let's go. I'm going to trust you.
I'm gonna go quite far.
Okay.
Yeah,
just going to bring it back just a little bit.
No, she can't.
So, I really don't want to fall off this.
No, I don't want you to fall off this.
Here?
Yeah, you go with your gut.
Yeah.
Let's extend.
Let's extend straight to it.
Yeah, yeah.
Okay, here we go.
Oh, look at that lovely, confident extending.
Yeah, it's way longer.
What a brave boy. It... Oh.
No.
You jester.
It is longer.
Oh, so it can go over.
Oh, my God.
It can go over.
See, I didn't know. Too far.
The team of three.
Take it.
We're moving on to tape measure.
A tape measure is meant to measure everything in the house. So that's going to go so far.
What have we seen, John?
Two timesness.
What?
I'm tempted to not even move that.
What would happen if we got some Russell Watson played in?
What?
Oh, no, neither.
It's a jumbo one, this.
All right, so it's a team of two.
How about this?
Yeah, make sure it's in front of the thing, yeah.
Locking them.
Let's extend. Such a silly man.
Yes. That is it.
Really?
Yes, well, it does say two times N-E-S. Two times N-E's, that's, of course, two times Noel Edmonds is. All the information was on the tape measure. So the team of two gets another point.
Congratulations. I'm pretty excited about the ladder. Is it the ladder now?
It's ladder time, guys.
Yeah.
Do you think that is the length, the size of a house?
I don't know. I
say go over the thingy. Go over the nappy. Right, on the brink.
Do you think?
On the brink.
On the brink?
Yeah, on the brink.
I don't think it's going to go that tall. Can I move it in?
Yeah, there.
Yes. Okay. Oh, wow. What a rush.
Team of three, you do need to win this one.
Every section of that extends about that. If we could lay Dara end to end...
It's a big if.
I think Dara's using his own system.
I just heard someone say, oh, no, up there.
Let's extend. Way past both is my prediction.
Oh, maybe it's a death.
Yes.
Hello. Oh. Hey.
No.
Oh, we're at the end.
What?
I think it's perfect.
Okay, so next goal wins, Greg. It's the red vacuum cleaner. This time it's being measured to where its face gets to.
Oh, so it's using the lead.
Exactly. We're measuring the extension lead.
Hello.
I'm pissed with anticipation.
Team of two, you're going first.
Yeah. I reckon this man is long enough to get to the edge.
Yeah.
What do you think?
I agree.
We have to commit.
I feel it off the edge.
All right. Cool. There we go.
Bold.
So bold. Brave.
Well, cleaners use this. It's not for normal households.
He's found his marker.
Just on the edge.
Come on, John.
Oh, he's gone bold.
3 seconds. Are you happy, John?
Two things. It was an act of madness. And secondly, who'd have thought someone would make this game genuinely exciting? But when the whistle went, the team of three were on the floor.
Ooh.
I did see where you placed it, and I think I've been true to that. Let's extend. Vacuum space.
Yes.
It's about the nozzle.
It's a short one. That's it.
Wait, does that mean we win?
The team of two win!
What's he talking about?
That's as far as it goes.
Let's add that up and see how it's affected the final score.
I'm all right. Everyone's a bit cross about the trick vacuum.
Yeah.
In the end, the team of two get 3 points, the team of three get 2 points. So well done, Sarah and Manya.
Wow. Yes.
Shall I tell you some scores?
Yes, please.
Well, in the series, oh, wow, Fern and John have exactly the same number of points, 113. Manya, 118 now. Sarah on 141, Dara on 142.
Ooh!
Oi, oi, oi. In this episode, John has 6 points. Dara 9, Fern 12, Sarah 17, Manya Chihuahua has 21 points!
Alas! Manya wins! Please go and party with your fancy dress! There's two shows left, but just one winner tonight. It is Manya Chihuahua!
Hello, Alex Horn here again. Please don't turn off just yet, because the Horn Section TV show is on next, and I have finally been promoted from assistant to genuine main guy. Yes, Greg is still in charge, but shut up, it's my show, and please watch.